गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन SST वी विल गो थ्रू चैप्टर 1 and 2 क्वेश्चन आंसर्स एक्सप्लेनेशंस, दैट इज शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन आंसर्स एंड डिटेल क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. सो आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट दोज क्वेश्चन आंसर्स विच वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन एंड आई टोल्ड यू दैट टुडे आई विल टेक योर रिविजन टेस्ट ऑफ डिटेल क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ चैप्टर 1 and 2. सो बी प्रिपेयर फॉर दैट. You can do it in your revision copy or in your rough copy. You can write only answers and show it to me. Okay? So today we will go through the very short question answers and short question answers and detailed question answers of chapter 1 and 2. And hope you have completed all your diagrams and question answers in your SST fair copy and exercises in your SST book. So let's get started. So students, this is the chapter 1 short question answers. What percent of the earth's area is covered with water? Approximately 71% of the earth's surface is covered with water. That you all know that 71% of the earth's surface is covered with water. Name the largest and the smallest continent. So Asia is the largest and Australia is the smallest continent. Then what is an isthmus? A strip of land connecting two mainlands separated by water is called an isthmus. When two mainland is connected with water area. Then what connects North America to South America? The isthmus of Panama connects North America to South America. Then what are oceans? Name the largest oceans in the world. So large water bodies on the earth's surface are oceans. Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean in the world. Okay. So this is your short question answer. And then chapter 1 detailed question answer is, what are continents? Name the 7 continents of the world in the decreasing order of their size. So large land masses are called continents. The 7 continents of the world in the decreasing order of their size are Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe and Australia. Now describe some features of Antarctica. So some features of Antarctica are, it is called the white continent. It is the 5th largest continent. It is the coldest, driest and the windiest continent. It is completely surrounded by the southern ocean. Then write 3 sentences about the Indian Ocean. So the Indian Ocean is the 3rd largest ocean, covering 20% of the earth's water surface. It is connected to the Mediterranean Sea by the Suez Canal. It provides major sea routes to the world. Then write a short note on the Southern Ocean. The Southern Ocean is also known as Antarctic Ocean, means its other name is Antarctic Ocean. It lies in the southern hemisphere. It encircles Antarctica and gets water through the merger of the Pacific, Atlantic and Indian Ocean into it. Means three oceans are merged into it. Then we come to the second chapter. Okay. Short question answers. What are longitude and latitude? So the imaginary lines running through the north and south pole are called longitudes. And the imaginary line running east to west and parallel to the equator are called latitudes. Name some important lines of latitude. Some important lines of latitudes are Arctic Circle, Tropic of Cancer, Equator, Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. Then what is the prime meridian? Prime meridian is the standard line of longitude assumed to be crossing the Royal Observatory in Greenwich near London. It is marked at 0 degree. Then how many lines of latitudes are there? There are 181 lines of latitude, 90 lines to the top of the equator and 90 lines to the bottom of the equator. Then detailed question answer. How do we find the location of a place on earth? See, any point on earth can be located by specifying its latitude and longitude. If we know its latitude and longitude, then these lines intersect each other forming a network called grid. I told you, this is the grid. So these lines provide the location coordinates which helps in locating a place on the globe. Who proved that the earth is spherical in shape? Many scholars believed that the earth was spherical in shape. In the 16th century, a Portuguese explorer, Ferdinand Magellan, set on an expedition. He died on the way, so his follower. The voyage was completed by his second in command, Juan Sebastian Elcano. He proved by circumnavigation that the earth was spherical in shape. Then third one is differentiated between longitude and latitude. So it is same, what is longitude and what is latitude. The imaginary line that runs vertically from the north to the south pole are all around the globe are called the lines of longitude or meridian. And latitude, the imaginary line circling around the earth from east to west and parallel to the equator are called the lines of latitude. So I have explained you the question answers, short also and detail also. And in homework, in revision test, I will give you questions in the group and you will write the answer and show it to me. Okay. Thank you.